Hi, my name is Jessica and I'm a senior instructional designer at Landing AI. I want to use LandingLens to detect wind turbines. I've already created a project and trained a model. Now we need to analyze how well the model performed after it was trained. Before I review my model's report, I want to see where the model made predictions on my images. First, I'll increase the image size. Now let's take a closer look at the images. There are two sets of labels on each image. The solid line represents my ground truth, and the dotted line represents the model's predictions. To make it easier to review them, I'll deselect ground truth so I can only see the model's predictions. For the most part, the model is very accurate. Now we'll take a look at the model's report. First is the confidence threshold. Each time a model makes a prediction, it outputs a score that represents how confident the model is that its predictions are accurate. By default, LandingLens displays a confidence threshold with the best F1 score for all my labeled data. In machine learning, an F1 score measures how accurate a model is by combining the precision and recall scores. If you don't know what precision and recall are, that's okay. I'm going to explain it soon. In my case, the best score for my data is a confidence score of 0.28. This means that when the model makes a prediction, and the model is at least 28% confident that its prediction is correct, the model will make a prediction. However, if the model is 27% confident or less, the model will not make a prediction. Ultimately, the confidence score is the standard for making predictions when the model is deployed. The next set of metrics is precision and recall. Both of these metrics represent mathematical equations. To understand what this means, let's take a look at what each term in these equations represents in my use case. True positive means the model predicted a wind turbine in an image, and the model was correct. True negative is when the model predicted a wind turbine was not in an image, and the model was correct. False positive means that the model predicted a wind turbine in an image, but the model was incorrect. Lastly, false negative is when the model predicted a wind turbine was not in an image and the model was incorrect. Let's take a look at the precision equation one more time. The score tells me the percentage of positive predictions the model made and answers this question. When my model says a wind turbine is present, how often is it actually correct? If the precision score is high, the model is more likely to be accurate when it predicts a wind turbine. Ultimately, precision is the model's ability to be correct when it says something is true. Now let's review the recall equation. This score tells me the percentage of wind turbines my model detected and answers this question. Out of all the wind turbines in my images, how many did the model identify? If the recall is high, the model is good at finding most of the wind turbines. Ultimately, recall is the model's ability to find all objects of interest. The last section of this report shows the number of correct and incorrect predictions. Each number is a filter. This is useful so I can quickly spot check the correct predictions. And more importantly, see where my model made incorrect predictions. In this image, my model did not make a prediction, which looks understandable because the wind turbines are difficult to spot. Because they are small in this image, I can click the thumbnail to see the original image. These are the wind turbines that the model was unable to detect. For my use case, I think it's okay if the model misses these ones, because they're so far away from the camera. However, if I want my model to improve its ability to detect wind turbines from a distance, I can upload more images that represent wind turbines from far away and then retrain my model. If you're happy with the model's performance, you're ready to move to the next step, deploying your model. If you want to fine-tune your model, you can continue adding images, updating labels, and retraining. Developing a model that meets your needs can be an iterative process, and the confidence, precision, and recall scores will help guide you through it. Visit the Landing AI Support Center and community for more information.